inside Oracle Park, the home of the Giants, as we're ready for baseball from the city by the bay. Today we've got a good matchup in store between the New York Yankees and the Cleveland Indians. Going to be an interesting contrast in styles in this one, as one of baseball's hardest throwers goes head-to-head with a top finesse arm. Next. Now to the plate, here is DJ LeMahieu, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. Two balls and a strike now to the Yankees leadoff man.
Two on the count.
Our temperature should get us up into the 70s as we move along. 68 at first pitch.
I got to count.
Two and two. Into the windup and the pitch. Count remains 2-2. Here's the pitch.
Gotta love the battle we're seeing right out of the gates in this game. That's seven pitches now, and if this is any indication, we're in for a good contest here.
And that misses ball four, so a good battle to begin the ball game today, but the leadoff man will reach first anyway. Fastball laid off well below the knees.
He's having a really hard time finding his rhythm and finding the strike zone. It's going to allow this offense to keyhole him in big situations. He's got to figure it out pretty quick.
And boy, that misses as well. It's back-to-back walks to start out the inning. LeMahieu over at second. Rizzo first with no outs. Softly hit toward the hole. He indeed takes only the out at first as the runners move to second and third with one away now. So runners in scoring position, and here is Giancarlo Stanton looking to put them ahead early with this at bat. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two. Two men on, two out, and that'll bring up Joey Gallo. The set and the 1-1.
Nope, that's down.
Breaking ball called just a bit low. Strike swinging, timing a little off on that one.
You know, this isn't a ballpark that yields a lot of runs, so when you've got a chance like this to put some early runs on the board, it becomes...
That will leave it right there as he strikes out, and that ends the inning. So now, here is Miles Straw. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Now the 1-1 pitch. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. Judge is over a few steps toward the line, and he has it for the first out. Next, here is Ahmed Rosario. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Clearly off with his timing on that one, a swinging strike.
When you get yourself to a 3-1 count and you get a fastball, those are the ones you really want to punish. Couldn't get the bat on it, so we'll see if that comes back.
Batting third.
Digging in, the switch hitter, Jose Ramirez. His career line against Gerrit Cole. A number of meetings, he's 1-for-7. To 2-2 now.
Two strikes.
Up the line as it gets away. Runners on first with one down. Shin-high fastball that time, ball three.
Defense has got to be on their toes right here. 3-2 count, runner on first has got some serious wheels. You know he's probably being put in motion.
Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out. And that'll bring in Franmil Reyes. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. And he misses low here, so the count goes to 3-1. Three and two, full count.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Ready with the payoff pitch. Got him swinging as he runs the fastball by him to end the inning. Second inning set to go, and that will bring up Gleyber Torres. The 1-1 home. Waves and misses for strike number two. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Swing and a liner toward the gap in left center. And that'll get down out there near the wall. And the Yankees are in business here. It's a leadoff double. Stepping in now, Gary Sanchez. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning. A man at second with one down. And up next, the left-handed hitting Brett Gardner. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. No score here as we play inning number two. Fouled off. Pulled toward right center field. Long run for the center fielder. He gets there to put it away, but the runner tags and breaks for third. And he's up to third safely now with two gone in the inning. So stepping in is Gio Urshela, runner in scoring position with two gone. Way outside, nearly to the backstop, 2-1.
One pitch shy of 40 for him right now, and he's not even out of the second inning of work. He's definitely not being as efficient on the mound as he'd like.
Even count, two balls and two strikes. The set and the 2-2. This is skied into short left center. In comes the left fielder. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. Set to lead off the home half of the second. Two balls and a strike. Here it comes.
Have an AB right here. I know it's frustrating the heck out of the pitcher. You keep fouling these pitches off, maybe one misses over the heart of the plate.
And it's fouled away. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Judge is going back. A leap, and he's got it. Impressive play for the first down.
Batting fifth.
Into the box, Harold Ramirez. The 1-1. Hit in the air down the right field line. Heading after it is Judge, but this will land untouched. The 1-2. Bottom of the second here with no score. Ripped on the ground to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. And that'll bring in the San Diego product, Bradley Zimmer. Trying to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. And the pitch on 2-1. waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in DJ LeMahieu, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. The 3-2 pitch. In the air down the line in left. Left fielder is on the move. Oh, and a great diving catch for the first down. So bases are empty with one gone, and into bat next, the left-handed hitting first baseman Anthony Rizzo. Two balls and a strike to the Yankees first baseman.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for beat stuff.
He stays alive, still 2-2. Two balls and two strikes to Rizzo. Taken off the outside as the breaking ball couldn't catch the corner.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
And that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit. At the plate now, Aaron Judge. And it's a ball and two strikes now to Aaron Judge.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Here now the 2-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Striding forward now, the Yankee cleanup hitter, Giancarlo Stanton. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. And he fouls this one off. Here comes the 1-2. Fouled away. Here he comes again, 1-2. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes. Bottom of the third now, and that'll bring in the veteran catcher, Roberto Perez. Thing has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. And ball good four, patience exercised as he works out the walk to lead off the home half of the third. So the next to bat will be Andrés Giménez. Good battle. Count remains full. Fouled off. Next 3-2 is in there, a called strike three. So the lineup flips over and digging in, Miles Straw. It was a flyout for him to start the home first. The 3-2 pitch. He could only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at-bat. Next, it'll be Ahmed Rosario. Worked a walk his first time up. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Now a swing and a miss at a slider for a strike.
I'll tell you, if I'm pitching right now, I'm not throwing anything near the strike zone until these guys prove they can lay off it. They're just being way too aggressive.
And he misses with that one down and in. It's a full count now, 3-2.
Good running count right here. Three balls, two strikes, two outs, runner on first.
We'll have to press pause as that strike three to retire the side. All set for the start of the fourth. And up to bat next, the left-handed light tower power of Joey Gallo.
The old adage, pitching and defense have been stellar so far. They've certainly kept both offenses in check.
And oh, strike three called on a fastball that looked inside from here, but that's out number one.
The second baseman, Labor.
Three and one pitch. Line towards center field. That's in another base hit. He's two for two.
Up next to the catcher, Gary Sanchez.
So now to the plate, Gary Sanchez. Well hit the other way, and it's into the gap. Final score is the Yankees have the early 1-0 lead. Into the box now, Brett Gardner, and it's fouled away. Here now the 2-2. Again, he sends it out of play. One run, four hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far. 3-2 to the Yankee center fielder.
Well, I think this is the kind of approach they need against such a prolific starter. You can't count on putting up a lot of runs, so getting him out of the game has to be the priority. Working at bats, full counts, running up the pitch count is a great way of doing that.
Got him to go down swinging there. Brett Gardner is sent packing for the second out of the inning. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1.
Good time to be a nine-hole hitter right now. More than likely going to get a good pitch to hit. The top of the order is looming on deck. Good spot to be a good hitter right now.
3-1 to him now. The 3-1 hit hard on the ground to the right, and that's through into right field for a base hit. And the runner at third will put the brakes on here as they didn't want to chance it even with two outs.
The batter, the third baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
In now, DJ LeMahieu, and he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
Now batter,
Anthony Rizzo stands in now. One of the bigger spots in the ball game so far. Base is juiced now with two away. A 1-1 pitch. And he fouls this one off. A 1-2 pitch. And he struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. Now to the plate, Jose Ramirez. He'll lead things off against Garrett Cole. Two balls and a strike, here it comes.
This guy's been throwing the ball great so far, but it's going to be tested here. 4, 5, and 6 coming up this part of the lineup.
And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
Great AB up until this point. A walk right here could really just infuse some confidence into this lineup.
Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Struck him out. Striding forward now is the DH, Franmil Reyes. He's 0-for-1 thus far. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And not a real good cut at that slider, and he's behind 1-2.
Wow, that's four straight Ks. He's knocking them down.
And there's the first hit of the game for Cleveland. Standing in now, Bobby Bradley. 2-1 to the Indians' first baseman. Looked like he tried to pull it there, but he swings right through the fastball. Set to deal on 2-2. Oh, and that's knocked down. Torres at the bag. Next up, Harold Ramirez. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Now a swing and a hard hit grounder. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Another full count pitch home. Count still full, 3-2. Another payoff pitch. And a good at bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away. The set and the 1-1.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Here's the 2-1. Breaking ball well inside and taken for ball three.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
High in the air into shallow left center. Urshela ranging into the outfield. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. All ready to go in the top of the fifth. And digging in is the outfielder, Aaron Judge. The 1-1 home. It's a fastball that misses. Now a drive by Judge. Deep left field. Into the bleachers and gone. At the plate, Giancarlo Stanton. Who jumped the gun a bit on that swing? He's down 1-2. And here in just the fifth inning, this will be pitch number 100 here.
That's a boy, pitch count up near 100 right now, D-Row. And this is when you try to get to a good starting pitcher. Right now, looks like he's running on fumes.
Yeah, the manager's got to get a couple people up in the bullpen right now. One ball hits the gap. They get runners in scoring position. This game could be out of commission.
Counts even 2-2 to Joey Gallo.
Hey, boys, you talking about getting your ace swing off right here? That's what it looks like. A guy with massive power, let it eat.
Got him! And he goes down on strikes for the third time.
The second base.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Lifted down the line in left. And this will wind up a foul ball. Yet another strikeout here. His 11th of the ball game, and this one ends the inning. At the plate now is Roberto Perez. Worked a walk in his first plate appearance. Now the 2-1 pitch.
Ball three.
A 3-1 count, tying run on deck. Good spot to be a hitter right now. You have to look for something middle in.
And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Not much you're going to do with that pitch right there. You have to catch it out front before it even breaks. And even if you do that, it's a tough pitch to keep fair.
And he will whip this one over to first in time for the out. Andres Jimenez, the next at bat, comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. 1-1 home. And he struck him out. Good pitch there as he registers his 8th punch out of the ballgame. So the batting order turns over now and set to go Miles Straw. He was punched out looking at strike three last time through. To short. Throw in time and the side is retired. Kristen McKenzie takes over to start the 6th inning on the mound.
Number 24.
Top half of the 6th about to get started. And now it'll be the catcher, Gary Sanchez. Hit on the ground is short. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the 6th. So here is Brett Gardner. No hits to this point. One out, nobody on. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. And this is swung out and missed, so it's two up, two down to start the sixth inning. That'll bring in Giovanni Urshela. One for two in the ballgame thus far. Starts to go around, but the home plate umpire says he held up ball two. And this one's low here, so the count swells to 3-1. DJ LeMahieu would be next. Strike two, swinging just out in front of the slider. Popped him up. Perez is under this one, and that will retire the side. Of the sixth inning now, and coming forward now is the shortstop Amed Rosario. The 2-1 home. Hit in the air down the right field line. Judge is on his horse, and he makes the catch in the corner. Next to hit, Jose Ramirez is hoping to avoid the hat trick. He struck out in each of his first two plate appearances so far. Now the 1-1 pitch. Misses, ball two.
Couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat, trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
Fouled away.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot, time for them to get back in this game with a couple quality ABs.
Fouled off. Another try at 2-2. Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call. Franmil Reyes will be next. Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one. Next for the Indians is the designated hitter, Franmil Reyes. He was a strikeout victim his first trip and then collected a base hit his last time around. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Could have been 3-1. Instead, it's 2-2.
This offense has just been flailing at the plate all game long, so it's no wonder why they've only been able to pick up one hit so far. I'm not seeing much of a game plan from these hitters.
At the plate now, Bobby Bradley to 2-2 now.
Looks to me like he's just trying to do too much up there at the plate. That's an easy trap to fall into when you're the tying run, but
a swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. New inning set to get underway, and standing in is the veteran third baseman, DJ LeMahieu. Here it comes on 1-1. And a changeup that just about got away from him there as that ran in a bit too far.
That was a changeup, so there really wasn't any intent behind it. Looked to me like it just slipped out of his hand a little bit. That'll happen sometimes because of the grip of that straight changeup.
Strong comes on now, and he has it one down. The 1-1 home. Swing hard liner to left center, and that's in for his second hit of the afternoon. So now to the plate, Aaron Judge. Had the weight back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. Smoked on the ground up the middle. There's one. Back to first, and that was a sparkler. A double play, and the inning is over. plate Holmes gets the call from the pen to take the ball for the home seventh.
Number 35.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Harold Ramirez. Here's a shot to left field and deep. Look at this. And it's gone into the bleachers. Into the box, Bradley Zimmer. Swing and a miss. Good sinking action there. One and two.
Put that in a memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at bat going. Look out. That one almost got away from him. Two and two now.
That's a good pitch right there, but you know, as a base stealer, when you're in the box like that, you want to protect your money makers, right? You don't want anything around your knees or your feet, so he was fortunate to get out of the way of that one.
Gallo comes on and makes the catch in shallow left for out number one.
The catcher, number
next to dig in,
Roberto Perez.
He bounced out last time up.
Perez.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
And he lays off ball four, so now the potential time run here is aboard late in the game. Back up the middle. Torres at the bat. Relay to first in time, and just like that, this side is retired. Stanton now. Three at-bats for him in this one, all ending with him going down on strikes. Skied into straightaway right. Waiting on it is Zimmer. One away. So that brings up the big bat of Joey Gallo. He went down on strikes last time up. Our pitcher's duel continues here. 2-1 score as we play the eighth. And he'll strike out here yet again, as it's been a ballgame to forget thus far. Four strikeouts. Next up is Gleyber Torres. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch.
Well, the play's been made, and with it comes the end of the inning. Chad Green is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 57.
Bottom of the inning now, and at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Miles Straw. The 1-1. He's in there for strike number two.
Hey, that's a great job by the pitcher right there, stealing a strike with that get me over breaking ball. And now he can get a little nastier with it in the dirt.
Swing and a miss at one in the dirt. Sanchez gathers, and he makes the throw to first. Strong is retired, and there's one away. Digging in next, Ahmed Rosario. In his career against this pitcher, he's 0 for 5. The 3-2 pitch. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Digging in will be Jose Ramirez. Not providing much out of the three hole in this one. Hitless in three at bats so far. All even now, 2-2. One run on three hits. No errors to this point for the Indians. Still even at 2-2.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
2-2 one more time. He's laid off, and the count runs full.
Tried to backdoor him and lock him up with a curveball right there. Pretty good pitch, but he didn't quite get it to come back.
We'll have to press pause as that strike three to retire the side. All set to start the ninth in this one, and digging in is the big time power threat, Gary Sanchez. Oh, and he was fooled that time on the pitch away as he went around for strike two. Ground ball, left side. And a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out. Up next, Brett Gardner, who could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. And he popped him up over toward the left side of the infield. And he'll squeeze this one for the second out. Now with the plate is Gio Urshela, popped into foul ground his last time up.
Yeah, Matt, he's got to make an adjustment right here. His swing definitely broke down, dropped his back shoulder, and thus the result was a terrible pop-up foul.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
And he takes ball four, so a good job out of the nine hole in getting on base as we go back to the top of the order. Halfway to 100 pitches, here it is. Struck him out, so it remains a one-run lead as they head in for their final set of swings. Aroldis Chapman comes out of the bullpen to shut things down here in the ninth.
Number 54.
All set for the bottom of the ninth. And standing in is the DH, Franmil Reyes. Chapman ready, the 1-1. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. And he's really given some leeway on the outside edge here. 2-2 now.
Ooh, that was some gas. Triple digits on the radar gun.
Torres picks it up. Throws in time, and that's out number one. Now at the plate, here is Bobby Bradley. He went down on strikes in his last at bat. Pulled hard, but it's foul down the first base side. Seventh pitch of the at bat coming up. That is swung on and missed, and things are starting to look bleak here for the home nine. There are two away now. Chapman sets 1-1 on its way. Last strike now for Cleveland. And it's fouled away. And that's going to be high, 2-2 now.
Man, this guy's a grinder. Fouls off good pitches and doesn't seem to swing at the ones just off the corner. This guy's a pitcher's nightmare.
2-2 pitch is fouled away. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. Swung on and hit deep to left center. This one has a chance. Gallo is there. Makes the catch and the ball game is over.
Man, facing Chapman is not for the faint of heart as he unleashes fireball after fireball. Gets the final out here and another save. What a weapon Chapman is.
Pitching and defense game, 2-1, the final score this afternoon. The New York Yankees took the lead in the fourth and held on until the end. Gerrit Cole earns the victory on the mound. Shane Bieber takes the loss despite striking out 11 batters. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
Our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Yankees, 2 runs, 7 hits, no errors. They left 9 runners on base. for Cleveland. One run on three hits. No errors. They left six men on base.